Blackstone presents The Heart of Stars by Kate Forsyth. This book is read by Elle Newlands. For Greg, always. Life itself is but the shadow of death, and souls departed but the shadows of the living. All things fall under this name. The sun itself is but the dark simulacrum, and light but the shadow of God. Sir Thomas Browne, The Garden of Cyrus, 1658. The story so far. Onehorn's daughter is not like the other satyricorns of her herd. Born of a human father, she has failed to grow the horns that mark her place within her herd. Soon, she knows, the other satyricorns will kill her. Her only chance is to escape. But how can she possibly outrun the swift hunters of her herd? One day, a young man, Connor the Just, rides into the Satyricorn's territory and is captured. He begs Onehorn's daughter to help him escape, for he is one of the Rye's own elite guard, and he carries news of dire importance to Lachlan the Winged. She cuts him free, but only because she has escape plans of her own. Onehorn's daughter dreams of capturing one of the fabled black winged horses of Ravenshaw and flying to freedom. To do this, she needs Connor's saddle and bridle, and besides, she empathizes with his urgent desire to get free of the brutish satyricorns. However, when the herd hunts Connor down and he threatens the life of her mother, Onehorn's daughter shoots him in the back, as much to hide her own betrayal as to save the life of her mother. As is the way of satyricorns, she hacks out all of Connor's teeth and cuts off his little finger to add to the necklace of bones she wears about her neck, and claims all his belongings as her own. With their help, she captures a winged horse and so is able to escape her herd. Exhausted and injured, she and the winged horse are discovered by Lewen McNeil, son of the tree shifter Leland. He tends her and the horse and gives her a name, Rhiannon. In the old tales, Rhiannon had been able to ride so swiftly none could catch her. Lewen is on holiday from his studies at the Theergia, the school for witches in Lucersery. It is decided he should escort Rhiannon and her winged steed Blackthorn through Ravenshaw to Lucersery, in the company of a journey witch, Nina the Nightingale, her husband Ivan and son Rodin, and a group of young acolytes wishing to be admitted to the witch's school. On the way, the body of Connor is discovered in the river. Wanting to carry the news back to the Rye as quickly as possible, Nina and Ivan decide to take the shortcut through the Valley of Fetterness, past the ruined Tower of Ravens, even though they are warned that the old witch's tower is haunted and the valley cursed. For 25 years, young boys have gone missing, graves have been robbed, and ghosts and revenants walk the fields and woods. Confident of her powers, Nina ignores the stories and pushes on. A storm forces the little party to take refuge at Castle Fettercairn, which guards the ruined tower. The chatelaine of Castle Fettercairn is a strange old woman named Lady Aveline, who is still grieving for the loss of her husband and young son during the reign of Maya the Ensorceller. The little boy's ghost haunts the castle. Only Rhiannon can see him clearly, though many of the other acolytes are fearful and disturbed by the dark atmosphere of the castle. The ghost of the little boy, who is just the same age as Rodin, awakes Rhiannon one night and shows her a room filled with the ghosts of hundreds of murdered boys, begging her to help them. Terrified, Rhiannon flees and stumbles upon a secret passage to the Tower of Ravens. There she discovers Lord Malvern, the Lord of Fettercairn Castle, attempting to raise the spirit of his brother, with the help of a circle of necromancers. Instead, they raise the spirit of a malevolent queen. She promises to help Lord Malvern find the secret spell of resurrection so that he may bring his dead brother and nephew back to life. First, though, Lord Malvern must resurrect her. Rhiannon's presence is sensed by the ghost, and she flees back to the castle to warn Nina and the others. They do not believe her, though, thinking her ill or dreaming. Then Nina and Lewen overhear Lord Malvern and his sister-in-law planning to kill Rhiannon to stop her revealing what she saw. They also seem to have sinister plans for Roden, who looks very much like Lady Eveline's dead son, Rory. Nina decides they must flee the castle as quickly as possible. Rhiannon, meanwhile, has escaped on Blackthorn's back, convinced her life is in danger. Lewen pursues her and persuades her to go back, so that they all may leave without arousing suspicion. However, a great storm blows up, and Lewen and Rhiannon are forced to take refuge in the Tower of Ravens. Here, they unwittingly drink from the Cup of Confession, an ancient relic that had been given to Connor many years before. Enchanted by the goblet, Lewen and Rhiannon declare their love for each other and consummate their desire. Lewen then discovers the necklace of bones and teeth, and Rhiannon admits that she killed Connor. Lewen is shocked and horrified and leaves Rhiannon, who flees. In the morning, Lewen again drinks from the goblet, and then when he contacts Nina through the tower's scrying pool, is compelled to tell her what he has discovered, even though he feels as if he is betraying Rhiannon. She tells him to contact the Rye and tell him all their news, which he does. The Rye is most distressed by the news and commands Lewen to bring Connor's murderer back to Lucerceri to face justice. Unhappily, Lewen goes in search of Rhiannon and manages to save her from being shot by Lord Malvern's men. She is bound and locked up in one of the caravans, and the small party set out once more on their journey to Lucerceri. In the next town, they are told an old tale that sheds much light on Lord Malvern's behaviour. He had once been an apprentice at the Tower of Ravens but was expelled. Hating all witches, he had become one of Maya's seekers, using his extrasensory talent to search out witches and fairies during the time of her reign. One day he arrested a young girl and condemned her to death by burning. She was held in the dungeons at Fettercairn Castle, where his brother Faulkner was lord. Then Lachlan the Winged and his band of rebels sneaked into the castle to rescue her. Lachlan fought a duel with Lord Faulkner and killed him, not knowing the Lord had hidden away his young wife, Eveline, and their son, Rory, in a secret room. For more than a week, they were trapped in the secret room, and the little boy eventually died of cold and hunger. Lord Malvern and Lady Eveline were both driven half mad by this tragedy, and spent the next 25 years seeking to raise their loved ones from the grave, and searching for a way to have their.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.